Singene nakulena inkonzo siyibolekwe nguThixo ngamazwi amafutshane omthandazo. Siswela phambi kobuso bakho Thixo wethu olungileyo ngentobeko nangenqoboko ngethemba Nkosi elungileyo lokuba wena nathi uza kusikhokhela Nkosi elungileyo nakulena inkonzo. Bakuthi ke Nkosi elungileyo amazwi omlomo wami imidlinzo yenhliziyo yami uthandeke kwamkeleke phambi kobuso bakho. Kuyona Nkosi ndinciphe mina ngoKristu inkosi yethu ngoku kude kube kunaphakade. Amen. Rhamente masilayite leli khandlela elisikhumbuzo sokukhona bukaNkulunkulu phakathi kwethu. Nginesifiso sokuba silayite leli khandlela namhlanje njengomthandazo esiwenze egameni leNkosi enguKristu, siwenzela bonke abantu abazisebenzayo, the self-employed, ngesi sikhathi sale COVID-19, lapho imisebenzi yabo kumbe izinkampani zabo zibonakala zi-under threat to survive. Sisondela ke ngokholo olupheleleyo ukuthi kuloyo nawo amandla wokushenxisa bonke ubumnyama obungenathixo makavela nenzela inceba nina namakhaya enu ngoku kude kube semaphakathini. Amen. Masisondeleke kunye kusisifundo sevangeli engcwele ngokubhalwa nguMarko isahluko sika-8 sifunda kuverse 27 siyoma kuverse 28. Waphuma uYesu nabafundi bakhe waya emzini waseKhasariya uFilipu. Waya endleleni babuza abafundi bakhe esithi kubo, kuthiwa ngabantu ndingubani namna? Baphendula ke bona ngokuthi bathi nguYohane umbhaphathizi, abanye bathi ngu-Eliya, bambi ke bathi ungomunye wabaprofethi. Lizwi lamazwi kaThixo wethu, Thixo makasikelele ukufundwa kweli zwi lakhe ngoku kude kube semaphakadeni. Amen. Rhamente sidibana kwakhona kulesi sifundo sethu esinguchungechunge sikandiyakholwa. Siyihlangana ke namhlanje kwisonto lesibili ukusondela kulesi sigaba sikandiyakholwa esikhuluma ngoKristu. Fumane Rhamente ngisondele kule ndawo ethi nakuYesu Kristu unyana wakhe emnye inkosi yethu wamithwa ngomoya ongcwele wazalwa yintombi uMaria. Ukuba khona kwale nkolo yabapostoli siyibiza ngondiyakholwa, intsingiselo nomsusa uma kube khona le nkolo isukela kwizingxoxo nemibono yebandla engafaniyo mayelana nobukhosi nobuNkulunkulu bukaKristu. ngenxa ke yobuningi bolwazi nomlando oqukethwe yilesi sigaba masikhuluma ngobuNkulunkulu bukaKristu. Ngibona ukuthi mangizahlukanise namhlanje siyikhulume ngalesi sigaba sokuqala, kuzothi ke ngesonto elilandelayo sikhulume ngesigaba sesibili, okuyisigaba lapho sikhuluma khona ngokuhlukunyezwa nokufa nokuvuka kukaKristu. Ngokomlando sifumana into ethi ibandla ngeminyaka yabo 300 lalibonakala lidunguzela lixabana kubangwa imibono eyahlukeneyo ngokuthi ngubani uJesu Kristu. Wawukhona ke omunye wabefundisi kumbe ubishop webandla lamaKristu owayebizwa ngu-Arius. U-Arius wayekholelwa ukuthi uKristu akayena uNkulunkulu, futhi wayekufundisa lokho ngaphandle kwamahloni engakugqizi iqabala-ke ukuthi abanye bacabangani. Lo mfundisi ke kwaze kwabizwa umhlangano ngonyaka ka-325 kwidolobha elalikhokhelwa uConstantine kuleli lizwe namhlanje sisilibiza ngeTurkey. Uma lo mhlangano ubizwa ngukumkani uConstantine ebona ukungazwani kwebandla, ebona ukuthi kungaba nomthelela ekuchitheni nasekuphazamiseni ukuthula okukhona ezweni lonke ayelikhokhela. Wabiza ke wonke amabandla ukuthi mawahlangane akhulume avumelane ukuthi kule nkolo yobuKristu indawo kaKristu ke ikephi kuyona yonke lento. Bahlangana bamlalela ke lo mfundisi u-Arius. U-Arius wayibeka ke eyakhe indaba. Mayibeka eyakhe indaba ubeka into ethi ngiyavuma ukuthi uKristu wayenamandla futhi wayembathiswe ngobukhulu ubuprofethi. Kodwa ukuthi sifike kwizinga lokuthi sithi uKristu wayenguNkulunkulu, hayi noko sesenza iphutha. Ekwenzeni kwethu ke iphutha lalokho, siphakamisa umuntu ozalwe ngokwenyama, samphakamisa samenza uNkulunkulu. Le nto iza kusidonsela amanzi ngomsele enze ukuthi bonke abantu abakhombisa isiphiwo sokuprofethi, isiphiwo sokuphilisa abantu, isiphiwo esifanayo naleso esichazwa ukuthi uKristu wayenaso ngokwevangeli, bonke ke kumele ukuthi sibabize ngoNkulunkulu. Walalelwa ke lo mfundisi u-Arius. Mayelalelwa lo mfundisi u-Arius ekugcineni uthi uKristu wayengumprofethi nje onikezwa amandla, kodwa kayena uNkulunkulu. Wakhiwe wadalwa njengam nawe, ngaleyo ndlela asikwazi-ke ukumbiza ngoNkulunkulu. Inkulumo ka-Arius isho ukuthi ngamanye amazwi nale nto esiyibiza ngoNkulunkulu oziqu zintathu, the Trinity, akusilona iqiniso, futhi akumele ukuthi abantu bafundiswe le nkolo yoNkulunkulu njalo. Lathi emva kokuba lilalela ibandla ingakumbi umfundisi u-Athanasius aphendule ngokuthi uma wena Arius nalaba bakulandelayo nikholelwa kule nto echazile, ngamanye amazwi nina niyalichitha iBhayibheli, ingakumbi imfundiso esiyithola kwivangeli engcwele kaKristu ngokubhalwa nguJohane. Ekuqaleni wayekhona uNkulunkulu, ekuqaleni uNkulunkulu waba ngulizwi. Ulizwi loyo waba inyama, waphila phakathi kwethu. Intsingiselo ke kandiyakholwa isukela kulo mhlangano ka-325 AD kuleli dolobha laseNasiya. Lavumelana ibandla kulo mhlangano ukuthi le nto efundiswa ngu-Arius ngamanga ngamampunge ngubuxoki nobuvuvu kumele ukuthi ibandla libuchithele ngaphandle. abagcinanga ngokuchitha izimfundiso zika-Arius kodwa abachitha naye njengomunye wabefundisi nobhishophu bebandla walahlelwa ngaphandle okwenyongo yenyathi. Kwasukeka lapho-ke laselithi kibandla siyakhumbula ukuthi ngokwezimfundiso zezibhalo zeBhayibheli kwincwadi kaMarko kuchapter 8 kunalo mbuzo uKristu awubuzayo uma ehamba nabafundi esuka kwindawo yaseCasaria Philippi athi kubafundi, aningitsheleni-ke ekuhlaleni abantu bathi mna ndingubani. Ibandla-ke ngo-325 libuyele emuva ukuzama ukuphendula lo mbuzo ukuthi ungubani uKristu. Okwanamhlanje ngifuna ukuzama ukusondela ukuthi sizame ukukhumbula ukuthi ibandla ekusekeni kwalo lalithi uKristu ungubani. Lahlala-ke ibandla ngo-325 labhala inkolo ebizwa nge-Nicene Creed. I-Nicene Creed iyona eyokuqala lapho kwiminyaka elandelayo kwakhelwa phezu kwayo lokho esesikubiza nge-Apostles' Creed, inkolo yabapostoli. Into eyenzakalayo ngenkolo yabapostoli ibonakala ithathwe yasuselwa kuNicene Creed ka-325 indlondlobaliswa libandla lakumazwe asentshonalanga, the Western Church. Kanti Nicene Creed yona yabonakala iyimfundiso yebandla elisempumalanga, the Eastern Church. Kuzombili-ke lezi nkolo ubukhulu ziyefana, zehluka kwizindawo ezithile ezingenzi umehluko uzube mkhulu. Ibandla-ke lasentshonalanga yibandla leli thina njengamawisili esiqhamuka kuphiko lalo, njengoba sazi ukuthi uJohn Wesley uqhamuka from the Western Church, amazwe aseEurope okuyiwona aletha inkolo yobuKristu kwilizwekazi lase-Afrika, aletha phakathi kwezinkonzo inkonzo yobuweseli. Sase-ke siyithatha kanjalo-ke, si-inherita kanjalo lento esiyibiza ngenkolo yabapostoli. So masicula njalo ngenkolo yabapostoli uma sihlangene ngamasonto, sisuke kahle kahle sisho ukuthini? Sisuke sizama ukusondela kumbuzo wevangeli uKristu abuza abafundi bakhe, abantu bathi mina ngingubani? Siphenduleke thina sithi, wena unguNkulunkulu owazalwa, owamithwa ngomoya oyingcwele, wazalwa yintombi Maria, futhi wena uyindodana kaNkulunkulu. Zisho ukuthini-ke lezi zinto esiziphimiselayo ngemilomo yethu njengemfundiso eshwankatheleyo njengebandla lamaKristu? Le nto-ke ngamafuphi isho ukuthi, okokuqala, uma sithi wena Kristu, abantu bathi uyindodana kaNkulunkulu. Ngamanye amazwi basho ukuthi wena siyakholwa ukuthi unguNkulunkulu oyinyama ophila phakathi, kumbe owaphila phakathi kwethu njengabantu. Futhi siyakholwa ukuthi wena unguNkulunkulu. Ngamanye amazwi, you are 100% divine. You are also 100% human. Ngamanye amazwi, eyona nto esiyishoyo uma sivuma sicula inkolo yabapostoli, sithi siyakholwa ukuthi uNkulunkulu esimkhonzayo ngoKristu, kumbe onguKristu, unguNkulunkulu ongahlali emazulwini uma abantu behlukumezeka, uma abantu bethwele ubunzima, uma abantu bebhekene ngqo nempi kaSathane, uma abantu bebhekene nokuphela kwemisebenzi, uma abantu bebhekene nezifo ezingalaphekiyo, uma kwenzeka iziphithiphithi emhlabeni, sithi thina siyakholwa ukuthi wena uyindodana kaNkulunkulu eyaba nguNkulunkulu, yaba futhi yinyama ukuze isuke emazulwini yehlele emhlabeni ibe phakathi kwethu ihambe kunye nathi ngamaxesha okuxakeka kwethu. Mandikhawulezeleke into ethi, akusho ukuthi ke uKristu ngoba wehla ezulwini waba ngumuntu ebantwini waphila phakathi kwethu ukuze ahambe nathi asikhaphe
kwizimo ezinzima kusho ukuthi izime ezimbi ngeke zisasehlela siza kusehlela futhi akusho ukuthi uKristu uzoba umuntu oyimagician umuntu ongumnomlingo ukuthi izinto bezimbi mazehlela abantu abakholwayo azichithe ngamandla obuthixo bakhe kodwa yena into azokwenzeka uKristu uza kusiphefumulela asinikeza ingqondo yokucabanga asinikeza amacebo asomeleza siqinise ekuhambeni kwethu ngezikhathi zokunzima sibonakale siqhamuka nezixazululo mase kuthiwa this is a human invention cha akiyona human invention kodwa ngamava nobulumko uKristu asipha bona njengonkulunkulu ophakathi kwethu njengonkulunkulu ohamba nathi ngithemba ukuthi ke abantu abadala kakhulu bayayazi lengoma kaBeth Midler ucula ingoma ethi from a distance God is watching us ngamanye amazwi uma sicula undiyakholwa sithi asikholelwa kuNkulunkulu osibukelayo sintshumpa ntshumpeka ngezime ezithile empilweni nesono esibukela ekude ehleze emazulwini kodwa sikholwa ukuthi owethu uNkulunkulu ungena nathi phakathi edabini nakumanje kwidabi lokuphela kwemisebenzi nokunqongophala nokuguqa kwezomnotho uNkulunkulu wethu uyehla asiphelezele asikhaphe ahambe nathi mzwe kwincwadi yeExodus uthi ngikuzwile ukukhala kwabantwana bami ngaleyo nto ke yesikhalo sabo ngehlile ukuze ngibahlangule kwisimo nakwinhlalo engalethi impilo. So ngamanye amazwi sihamba noKristu osiphelezelayo. Osiphelezelayo nangesikhathi sokuphela kwethemba. Kundiyakholwa sisuke sisho ukuthi thina sikholelwa kuThixo osiphelezelayo noma sisuke eJerusalema sibheka kwindawo yaseEmmaus lapho ithemba liphelile ngobo wethu uNkulunkulu simbonenekwa esiphambanweni. Khamente ngalenkolo yabapostile uma sithi siyakhola ukuthi wena ungunyana kaThixo sithi ngoba ungunyana shuthi uyinyama shuthi uphila phakathi kwethu shuthi uyazazi nezintswelo zethu iyona lento ke uma sifika kwizikhathi zobunzima nokuxakeka sizwakale sibiza kwigama likaKristu okwesibili sikushoyo kwinkolo yabapostile sithi wamithwa ngomoya oyingcwele wazalwa yintombi Maria lento ke yokumithwa ngomoya oyingcwele isho ukuthi isibeletho sika Maria besingena lutho as we know ukuthi sibeletho ukuze sibe nomntwana there must be something deposited by the other party but kwesi sibeletho sika Maria there is nothing because wethu uNkulunkulu esisho ukuthi sikholwa kuyena ngalenkolo yamapostile uyakwazi ukuthi kungekho lutho kodwa yena akwazi ukudala ngamanye amazwi uNkulunkulu akadingi ukuthi kube khona into kuzadale uyakwazi uNkulunkulu ukudala kwindawo engenalutho ifu uNkulunkulu ekwazi ukubeka kwisibeletho esingenako ukuhlangana nomuntu wesilisa kodwa abekwe impilo abekubuntu wabekwe impilo epheleleyo nakulemeko ke sikuyo la kuthi wakhona alikho neyeza nechiza nemishanguzo eza kusisiza ukuze sikwazi ukubhekana nesifo se-corona kodwa owethu uNkulunkulu uyasikhumbuza ngokuka ndiyakholwa ukuthi uyakwazi yena ukubeka umshanguzo kwindawo obungenawo umshanguzo anikezwe ukuhlakanipha nomqondo labo abangama scientists nalabo abasebenza ngokuhlanganisa amakhambi ukuze sizwe siphile uma sivuma ndiyakholwa sivumi kakhulukazi kulesi sikhathi esiphila kusona isikhathi sokuphelelwa lithemba sithi sikholwa kuNkulunkulu okwazi ukudala lapho kungekho lutho khona kubonakale udalwa impilo enja sithi siyakholwa ke kuNkulunkulu owangena umoya wakho engcwele wangena ngentombi uMaria,
the Virgin Mary.
Ngiyazi ke ukuthi yindawo le exoxisayo ikakhulukazi kubantu ababizwa ngama feminist. Bakhuluma into yokuthi siyabona ukuthi uNkulunkulu wenza njengongqowa nkulu. Labantu abathi mabefika uma bengabatholi abantwana bathenga abantu abantulayo bathi sizokuthenga ukuze wena usithwalele umntwana sikukhokhele ngesibeletho sakho wakuzala umntwana umlethe kuthina wena ke mesu uyahamba uqhubeke nempilo sesiyomkhulisa thina njengomntwana wethu lapha ekhaya njengenkosikazi nomyeni.
But this is not what is happening in the story. So kumithwa kuka Christu ngomoya engcwele.
Angithi masikhuluma ngomoya engcwele sikhuluma ngokuthi umoya engcwele in the language ye Bible, in the language of theology, sikhuluma ngokuthi ubonakala ngathi une element yokuba ngowesifazane. Ngamanye amazwi I element yomoya engcwele, it is an element ebonakala engathi ingumama, ebonakala ingumuntu wesifazane. Ngamanye amazwi umoya osondela ukukhuluma noMaria ngumoya uThixo afika ekhuluma noMaria sengathi ukwisimo sokuba ngumama nothi uNkulunkulu onguyise. Lokhu kwenza ukuthi sibone ingxoxo phakathi kukamama uMaria noNkulunkulu othatha isimo sobumama. Sengathi bakhuluma into yokuthi mfazi khawungisize. Ngifuna ukuletha icebo lokusindisa impilo nenhlalo yabantu. Kodwa ukuze kwenzeke lokho ngidinga usizo lwakho phela Nkosikazi ukuthi ungithwalele lo mntwana. Ogama lakho uya kubizwa ngokuthi ungu-Emmanuel ukuze zonke izizwe zomhlaba siphile. Kukule ngxoxo ephakathi kukaNkulunkulu ongumoya engcwele, the feminine God, the motherly God in character, in form and in shape, ehlangana noMaria. Bathi ke kuloku kuxoxa nokubonisana kwabo, uMaria beams with a smile, agqoke smile esihle uMaria, avume being charmed by this motherly nature of God that does not force herself into the womb but instead negotiates the way. Avume uMaria sengathi uthi lapho wena Nkosi ongithuma uba ngiye khona ngomsa wakho ngiyakulandela. Wavuma uMaria ukuthwala icebo lensindiso. So what do we mean? Masicula lenkolo yabapostoli ngoSunday. Ngamanye amazwi sithi siyakholwa ukuthi uNkulunkulu wanegotiate, wabonisana noMaria ukuze icebo lehlabathi liphumelele. Waze wathi ke uMaria wabizwa ngokwesiGriki ngoTheotekos. UTheotekos osho ukuthi the mother of God, the bearer of God, loyo othwele uNkulunkulu. Ngamanye amazwi ke inkolo yabapostoli masivuma. Siyazibophezela, sizinikezela nathi ukuthi nathi sicela ukuthi sibe ngabantu abazobamba iqhaza ekuzalweni kwemhlaba nemiphakathi namakhaya abonakalisa izimpawu zobukhona bukaKristu nobukhona bukaNkulunkulu. Ngamanye amazwi sifana nokuthi ingxoxo ephakathi kwamama ababili. Omunye usekhulile akasakwazi ukuthatha umntwana ambelethe emhlane ngoba usekhulile. Athi lo munye yekela ngimthathe lo mntwana ngimbelethe emhlane ngoba wami umhlane usakwazi ukubeletha umntwana ngoba ngisesemncane amandla ngisenawo. Ngamanye amazwi inkolo yabapostoli kulamavesi esikhuluma ngawo namhlanje siyazibophezela sizinikezela ukuthi asizukuyekelela abantu abahluphekayo sinako ukubathwalela nokubathwalisa imithwalo yabo kodwa siliba nokubahleka sizibophezelela ukuthi nathi sizofana noMaria othi nami ngicela ukuba yingxenye yecebo lensindiso ngicela nami ukuba yingxenye yecebo lokuletha impilo ebantwini. Ngamanye amazwi, uma sivuma undiyakholwa, sikholwa kuMaria owakumithwa ngomoya engcwele, sithi nathi sinakho ukuliletha icebo lensindiso kubo bonke abantu ngaphandle kokubheka inzuzo. Ngamanye amazwi, sithi nathi sifuna ukuthwala ubuThixo ngaphakathi kwethu ukuze nenkulumo yethu nangamazwi ethu akhayo kuphila abantu bezwakala abantu bethi ngihlangene nomuntu kaNkulunkulu hayi ngoba ehlangene nomuntu ogqoka ukhololo njengami kodwa ngenxa yokuthi inkulumo yakhe izenzo zakhe zithwele ziletha ubuThixo ziletha ubuNkulunkulu ukuze impilo ibe khona kubo bonke abantu ngalesi sikhathi ke sokuntula kwabantu abaningi sinako ke nathi ukuthi senze isipho esifana nesikaMaria isipho sokuthi nathi sibambe ikhaza ekuzalweni kwecebo lensindiso ukuze abalambileyo sibalulele isandla ukuze abakhatheleyo abadiniweyo sikwazi ukubaphakamisa kuze kuthi laba abaphelelwe lithemba ngenxa yokuphela kwemisebenzi sithwalisaneni imithwalo ngomthandazo. Uma sicula le nkolo yabapostoli asiculeli nje ukuthi kube mnandi kodwa it is a radical call to participate noThixo phakathi kwabo nakwimpilo yabo ekuzameni ukuletha impilo epheleleyo. Uyabuza kuKristu kubafundi bakhe uthi abantu bathi ngubani lokhu esengikubalile is a historical account about who is Jesus. Undiyakholwa kulesi sigaba ukhuluma about the historical figure of Jesus. Now next week sizokhuluma about the historical figure of Jesus owehlela eHades emva kokuba ebethele emnqamlezweni. Sikhuluma ukuthi kwenzakalani emva kokuba ebetheliwe emnqamlezweni ngesikhathi ehlele eHades. Kodwa kuyona yonke lento sidinga ukuthi siqaphele ukuthi ekugqibeleni uKristu sazophenduka abuze umbuzo ukuthi ke nina makholwa aseSt John's and North End naseHumut naseCentenary nithi ke nina ngingubani. Masiyibambe lapho ke namhlanje siyibamba ngesimemo sokuthi sonke masifinqe imikhono yethu ukuze sikwazi ukubamba ikhaza ekuzalweni kwemiphefumulo kumbe kwemiphakathi emisha ukuze kuphile imiphefumulo kukhanye lapho kumnyama khona ukuze uNkulunkulu akwazi ukusixhasa hambe nathi ngalesi sikhathi sokuxakeka ngenxa yecoronavirus. Egameni ke likaNkulunkulu odala izulu lomhlaba nasegameni likaNkulunkulu odale zonke izinto uNkulunkulu ke makasiphelezele sithwale ngawakha amandla masimlaleleke uNkulunkulu ekhuluma nathi ngale ngoma engunumber 14 esikhumbuzayo ukuthi uNkulunkulu wethu ukhona ezindaweni zonke futhi ukhona ngezikhathi zonke. asibambeni lapha ke hamente inkonzo yethu yanamhlanje ngethemba lokuthi uNkulunkulu uza kusiboleka amathuba ukuphinde sihlangane nangexesha elilandelayo. Nkulunkulu ke makanibuke, uNkulunkulu makakhanyise ubuso wakhe phezu kwenu namakhaya enu, uNkulunkulu makaningqonge ngaphambili nangasemva, uNkulunkulu makanenzela inceba nina namakhaya enu kusukela ngoku kude kube semaphakadeni. Amen.